Video games wouldn't be video games if you couldn't take control of things. Whether it's moving the player around or selecting different menu options, every game gives the player control over his or her own destiny. In a previous tutorial, I showed you how to draw sprites with the GBDK. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to handle Joypad input. If you need help, check out the description below for helpful links. If you have any questions, feel free to post a comment below and or check out the GBDK Discord server. We'll start this tutorial by drawing a basic sprite on the screen. We covered this process step by step in my last video, so I'll skip the in-depth explanations. In the video description, you'll find a link for the graphics used in this tutorial. Just like in the previous video, we'll download these graphics, drop them into our project, include them at the top of our main.c file, add the tile data into VRAM, and enable sprites on the Game Boy. In this tutorial, our object will use two 8x16 sprites, so we'll make sure to tell the Game Boy to use 8x16 sprites as well. In a future video, I'll show you how to use GBDK's built-in Metasprites implementation. This makes drawing multi-sprite objects really easy. However, while we're still covering the basics, we'll manually handle our sprites. We'll tell the Game Boy that our first sprite will use the first tile, and our second sprite will use the third tile. Recall, when the Game Boy sprites are in 8x16 mode, the next tile is automatically drawn below. This means that the second tile will be automatically drawn below the first, and the fourth below the third. Next, before we get into Joypad input, we'll set up four variables. The first variable we'll call player X, and the second we'll call player Y. These two variables represent the player's position. The next two variables we'll call Joypad Current and Joypad Previous. These variables represent the current and previous state of the joypad, respectively. All of these variables will be 8-bit unsigned integers and we'll declare them above our main function. We'll set the initial value of the player position variables to be 80, so it's in the middle of the screen. For the joypad variables, we'll set their default values to be 0. Our goal is to be able to move the player around in four directions using the Game Boy's D-pad. Additionally, when the player presses the A button, we'll reset the player's position back to the middle of the screen. At this point in time, our game loop just has a single function. This function, waitVBLDone, halts the Game Boy's CPU until the vertical blank phase is over. I'll spare you the details, just know this ultimately gives our game a consistent frame rate. At the top of our game loop, we'll start by saving the previous joypad state. We do this by copying the value of our joypad current variable into our joypad previous variable. This doesn't do anything the first time the game loop runs, but later it lets us test if a button was pressed in the last update. Next, we'll be reading the Game Boy's joypad state and saving it into our joypad current variable. For this, we'll use the GBDK function called joypad. It's important you only call this function once per update. That's why we're saving its value in a variable. This function takes no parameters and will return an unsigned 8-bit integer. The Game Boy has 8 different buttons. Each bit in our variable corresponds to a different button. We can tell if a button is held down by simply performing a bitwise AND operation with our joypad current variable. From there, we'll add basic if statements to change our player's position. GBDK comes with built-in macros for each button. We'll perform bitwise AND operations with the four D-pad directions, and then change our player's position when the operation is true. One important thing to remember, it might seem counterintuitive, but in order to move an object upwards, you need to decrease its Y value. Once we've done that, we want to set up the ability to reset the sprite's position via the A button. We'll perform a bitwise AND operation like with the other buttons. However, this time we'll also check if the A button was previously not pressed down. We do this again using a bitwise AND operation with our joypad previous variable, but this time making sure the result is false. If both operations are true, we'll set our player position back to the middle of the screen. The last thing to do in our game loop is actually move our object. Recall I previously mentioned our object was going to use two 8x16 sprites. This means we'll use the move sprite function twice. The first time we call move sprite, we'll pass the first sprite in our player's position. The second time we call it, we'll pass the second sprite and our player's position plus an additional 8 pixels to the right. If you compile and run, you should be able to move your sprite in four directions. If you press A, the sprite should reset back to the middle. If you hold down A, you should be able to move the sprite after its position resets. If we didn't compare against our previous Joypad state, the sprite would stay locked in the middle of the screen while the A button is held down. That's pretty much it for this tutorial. Like and subscribe if you found this video helpful. Stay tuned for more GBDK videos. Once all the basics are covered, we'll jump into more advanced topics and eventually into making small clones of popular games. Thank you and have a good day.